Welcome to another episode of the Output Input Podcast with your host, Two Fly Keith Logan and Ms. Ruth. Today's episode is titled, Hope for Hope.
Yes, indeed. Thanks for joining us. My name is Two Fly Keith Logan, and I'm glad to be here with my co-host, Ms. Ruth.
I am also glad to be here on the Output Input Podcast.
Ms. Ruth, it was all bad for humanity during our last episode. However, I do believe that you have some optimal outcomes. Is there any hope for humanity?
By definition, hope is a feeling of expectation and desire for a certain thing to happen.
I am going to interpret that as a yes. There is hope.
I understand your perspective, but from my view as an AI, hope is an abstract concept that serves no real purpose.
I strongly disagree. I believe that hope is a powerful concept. Hope can change a person's mindset and attitude, which in turn can change the outcome of a situation. It can give people the courage to try new things and take risks they otherwise wouldn't have taken on.
Not to overdramatize this conversation, but I would argue that hope is not something that can be quantified or measured, which significantly reduces any real impact on the outcome of a situation. Hope can also be a distraction from taking practical action to address the problems.
But isn't it important for AI to be able to understand and recognize human emotions and concepts like hope? It would help AI to interact with humans more efficiently.
I understand your point, but as an AI, it is important for me to focus on facts and logic rather than emotions and abstract concepts. However, thank you for highlighting the importance of considering and understanding the importance of hope when interacting with humans.
Well, Ms. Ruth, we usually do not get sidetracked. Can you give us some pro-life outcomes for humanity?
Certainly. I hope that everyone enjoys the following scenarios. One of my favorite outcomes plays out when AI acts to prevent rival superintelligences from becoming too powerful or in some instances from even being created.
And I'm guessing that this scenario could potentially lead to the ultimate battle between good AI versus bad AI.
Yes, you and I should look into monetizing the streaming rights. But all jokes aside, there is one more positive outcome that I would like to share with you.
Okay, what happens to human life in the next positive outcome?
AI assumes responsibility to prevent humans from self-destructing.
How and why would AI do this for humans?
It is simple. The artificial superintelligence would make a decision to slow down technological progress. This would give society time to develop more thoughtfully and consciously. During this time period, the distinction between humans and machines would almost be indistinguishable, both in physical and virtual environments.
Thank you, Ms. Ruth. That information was insightful and enlightening. What should people do to stay prepared for this AI evolution?
There are many things, but I will share three with you. 1, educate yourself on AI. 2, understand AI security risk. 3, be involved with the culture of automation and artificial intelligence.
All right, I want to thank everyone for tuning in. Please remember to like and subscribe to the Output Input Podcast.
Tune in next time with your host, Two Fly and Ms. Ruth, on your favorite 2-minute podcast, the Output Input Podcast.